Larry Foley, my gosh, what can I say about this guy? One of the most talented people I've ever been around in my life.
Whenever I think of Larry Foley, I smile, and then I chuckle.
Evelyn, you're telling me that people really buy some of this silly stuff you have here?
He was our assignment editor at a time at Channel 7 when I worked there. He was also our bureau chief at Pine Bluff for a time there.
Larry Foley, New Scene 7, Pine Bluff.
I've known Larry Foley about as long as I've known any human being. We started working together back in the 1980s when we were both a lot younger than we are now.
Larry and I laugh sometimes now that we have more stories from those 2 years of working in news that I was there than we do for all of the other years that we've worked together because it's such an intense thing.
He'd been on the job a little bit longer than I had, so when I called my boss to ask for help about what kind of a story I should cover, he gave me some very, very good advice. He said, call Larry Foley. He'll tell you what to do. And I did. And since that time, I've called Larry Foley numerous times for numerous reasons.
Larry was one of those guys that's done everything in the business. He's been on the assignment desk. He's been on the air. He's been a producer. But I think his favorite job at Channel 7 was being in the sports department.
The Baseball Hall of Fame is more than a museum full of old relics. It's a place where fans can come and actually relive some of the greatest moments in the history of the sport.
Not only does he love sports, but he was able to work with the legendary Paul Eales.
He was a great sports producer for us, and in the years since, he's been here at the University of Arkansas doing some incredible work, molding lots of young reporters and photographers and storytellers that have gone all across the country to do some great work.
You know, what Larry loves to do is he loves to tell stories. He's a storyteller.
It's because Larry sees past the surface of every story, and he goes to the heart and soul of the people he's talking about. And he knows that that is what makes a story work.
Of all the people that I've known in television, of all the people I've known in the news business, Larry has been one of the most dedicated, one of the people that really believes in the value of storytelling, and he has that in that contagious enthusiasm that he's spread to so many kids over the years.
No, it's not Cooperstown, but rather Flemister's Scorecard Collector Shop, a magic fantasy land for kids like me who've been buying bubblegum cards since they were old enough to count.
And I can tell you, I've never known anybody who has been more committed to storytelling or being a great journalist.